the gates of hell, but I won't back down. No, I stand my ground, won't be turned around. And I keep this world from dragging me down. Gonna stand my ground, and I won't back. Just one life in a world that keeps on pushing me around. Gonna stand my ground, and I won't back down.
Hey, baby,
there ain't no easy way out.
Hey,
stand
everybody.
What's up, you scoundrels?
Hey, Glow, Earth, AMAC, Road Rash, I hope your mom is doing as well as she can be.
Yeah, thanks for joining us, everyone. The True Jedi, Grain, what's up, Grain? Road Rash.
Oh, and Glow, good luck with the vacuum cleaner.
I'm sorry to hear that, Road Rash. Damn.
Oh, no, Road Rash. I am sending lots of love your way.
What's up, hey, Oki? Crispy, good to see you, Glow.
Glow,
yeah, Glow. That's the like a patch of image of the original Lemonhead candy box logo.
Glow says, "Good luck with what?" I'm not sure what that's referring to. She must be talking to somebody in chat.
Oh, yeah, I'm not sure. It was good to see her. I'm not sure.
She's trying to put a vacuum cleaner back together. Hey, SoFlo, Pookie, Lindsay.
What's up, AMAC? SoFlo.
Hey, Mrs. Fletcher. Sober Pug. True Jedi, good to see you. Grain. Grain says, hey, love you, scoundrels.
Filthy animals. Yeah, Road Rash, I'm really sorry to hear that. Like, we're here for you.
Yes, Amex. She said she was trying to put her vacuum back together.
Mrs. Fletcher, hello. Who texting? What's going on?
And Jeannie, good to see you. I haven't seen you in a while. I hope you're well. I hope your scrapbooking is going well too.
True Texan says, trying to keep my powder dry. That's always good advice. Hey, so can somebody, So anybody hear any good news stories lately? Any interesting things going on? Yeah, I thought somebody would have gotten that before if someone put a racial slur in there. I always find it odd that somebody said, you know, that person that does that, everyone's like, oh, they must be having a bad day. That's not what happens when you have a bad day. Everyone has a bad day. Could you imagine if that's how everyone acted when they were having a bad day? It would be a completely different world.
Hey, Tracy Esmay. And Jeannie, I'm so sorry. Jeannie said her mom passed away 3 weeks ago, so wasn't up for nothing.
Oh, sorry for your loss. Yeah, it seems like this is going to be a pretty somber live, huh? Sheesh.
Yeah, and Oki, I did see that they arrested four people in the missing mom's case in Oklahoma. I haven't been able to look into it yet, but I did see that.
Yeah, Unsupervised Maniacs has been crushing it, by the way, if you guys haven't been following videos.
Oh, I know her videos of Dolly Vision are right on.
I mean, but not only that, but she also has her community post. She shares like vital stories occurring missing people. She's just, you know, working on all cylinders, as they say. I recommend it to everyone. No matter who you're voting for in the upcoming lawsuit, Unsupervised Maniacs is doing the actual pertinent, you know, vital work that more YouTubers should be doing.
I agree. Hey, Earth, how are you? I saw you were in here earlier, but glad you're back.
I had a chance to see not all of, but most of Earth's live. It was so good. Again, someone else I recommend. I don't know. I just became familiar with Earth in the last, you know, 5 or 6 months. The live was really good, a healthy conversation. It was strange. I actually found myself agreeing with voices, which I never thought would happen. So fucking anything is possible. She was actually done pretty dirty the last couple of days. So.
And interestingly enough, who was the one that struck her? Was it the CS lady or a different person?
The CS lady has just went ham on her. Did just all kinds of unscrupulous shit. So.
Okay, because there was someone else who was streaming the B live today, and it wasn't the CS lady. It was a different lady live streaming her while she was live.
Oh, damn. I didn't even know she was live today.
Yeah.
I haven't been following. I've just been getting notes, you know, the highlights. I have a few things to say about it, of course, as you can imagine. We'll get into it. Hey, what's up, Spitfire? So, yeah, I mean, I would never agree. I don't even know Voice's whole past, but, I mean, this black and white facts are she was done dirty, so.
Right, because she was getting struck, like, over and over and over, repeatedly.
Yeah, there's a whole thing, yeah, and like, whoever the I'm not sure if it's the same person, but someone else, like, went real life and, like, it affected her family as well. So it's like, okay, that's, we all know families are off limits. Like, I mean, even the biggest scoundrels around here know that. Well, you know, not all of them, but they should anyways. It's a bare minimum. That should be, or, you know, a rule. Oh, Jeannie says it is the same person. Damn, that's just dirty. I mean, I don't know the whole situation. Because, Emmy, you went live while Earth was live, so I was going sort of back and forth.
Yeah, and then I went over to Earth after I was live and was listening, but I had missed, like, the first almost 2 hours, so.
That's pretty much what I listened to. But it was really good. And, I mean, the conversation was just smart and was, you know, active. It wasn't, didn't get stagnant. It was really good. One of the best I've seen in a while.
Oh, that one came as she was on Laura's panel. Okay, so CS. But CS wasn't the one live streaming B today. Well, B was live. Like, she was streaming Queen's live stream, which, as we know, is stream sniping.
Yeah, it's dirty business. But it turns out you can do it on Rumble, so stay tuned for a Sinner Rumble.
Oh, yes.
Community. I mean, they're basically saying, oh, we could just do it on Rumble. We could do whatever we want there. We could just, doesn't matter if you dox people or snipe their videos. Bitch, I could do the same thing. Are you silly? Okay. Let's go. Hey, what's up, Ryan?
Hey, Ryan. Good to see you.
But I mean, I'm not going to get into the trenches because, I mean, they've gone completely bonkers over there. So triggered. And they're back to attack number one, saying I didn't serve in the Marines. Yeah, good luck with that, you silly assholes. Like, who in their right mind would sit up here and say they served in the Marines when they didn't honorably? Like, what? That's such a pathetic attack, and also shame on you. I sincerely want to know. On whose fucking authority are you asking for my private documents about my military service and my serving in the Marines? Are you out of your fucking mind? Don't answer. I already know the answer.
Yeah, Glow, I agree with you.
I mean, I thought it would go without saying, you don't question someone's military service without reason. I'm not applying for a job with those motherfuckers. I wouldn't even eat a meal with them. I would rather starve with someone that's in this chat right now that I barely know than feast with them. There's a distinct misunderstanding of what's happening here.
Pookie, who is Brandy? Oh, AMAC, thank you so much for that. Orion, Jeannie, Tracy, Mrs. Fletcher, and Oki. Hey, Jenny, how are you? I've seen you around these streets.
Actually, let me just make a proposition here. Becky, since we are firmly on a first name basis now, there's one condition that I'll show you my DD214, and it stands. And we'll email you the link if you need one. Come on over, we'll cam up together. But first, before I show you the documentation, I want you to explain to me why you hashtagged cash cow in that missing boys case just the other day. Do you consider that boy a cash cow?
I think she's trying to call out everyone else for making him a cash cow.
But that's the only one that's not relevant. Everything else is FBI. It's irrational to me. It's an ugly look.
I find everyone using Sebastian's case to be gross.
Well, I mean, I can't explain to you how disturbing it is that she's talking about what having little bitch ass Timmy sit there, talk about what I had for lunch on a train or dinner on a train. And then they talk about missing and worse. Seconds later, they're the scum of the earth. Let's just face it. I have no fucking problem saying it. It's just what it is. I've always felt this way. Something else they say. Oh, he wanted to be part of the hive. No.
That's what was said?
We all know that's not true. Longer ago than 18 months, I was telling people, wow, what's up with that channel? They are garbage. And guess what? To this very day, I feel exactly the same fucking way. Never once tried to find grace with you pathetic ass motherfuckers. Never once. I see you for what you are. You're trauma pimps. You collect people with problems and you take advantage of them. And now this lawsuit, nobody ever gave a shit about the lawsuit. But the main thing is, just to be very clear with you, and you're like, oh, he's jealous of my money. Your money's not earned. You know, there's no envy in collecting money the way you do. If you worked hard for it, then maybe I'd envy your work ethic, but you don't work. You don't even produce content.
And Grain said she sure did along with family members, all the while making him her cash cow. It's disgusting.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's evident to me that, I mean, it's the same as being a tragedy pimp. But it's more personal because she collects people around her and does it to them. So I don't know what's more perverse, to be honest with you, but in my mind, they're equally disgusting and unacceptable. Yeah, I mean, I took the train down the coast and they spent 40 minutes talking about it. Tim, I'll be straight up. It was interesting to hear you use your big boy voice. I would have been so proud of you if anything you were saying was worth a fucking shit. Sitting over there telling me what I should and shouldn't do. Let me clear a few things up for you. You seem confused, boy. Number one, you can't keep fucking saying I support cancel culture, meanwhile being with a whole fucking tribe of vultures that are trying to cancel me. Do you realize how ridiculous that sounds? You say I'm against freedom of speech. Meanwhile, you're sitting over there with a bunch of heartbroken, lonely people, upset about what I've said, my words, my speech. You're backwards, you asshole. You're the one that seems to be against freedom of speech, boy. You're the one that's trying to cancel me. You and your little weirdos.
But if they're trying to cancel you, it would make more sense not to talk about you. Because usually when you don't talk about someone, people tend to forget about them. But if you keep bringing them up over and over and over for hours on end, it keeps them relevant. It keeps them at the forefront.
It's not about her money. I don't give a fuck how many super chats she gets. That makes no difference to me, I promise you. What is a problem is her making defaming remarks explicitly over and over again. And then whenever she realizes she shouldn't do that anymore, she has someone else do it for her. Fuck all of them, that's what I'm saying. No effect. Zero. I mean, the silver lining here is the next court date's the 17th and then the fucking ball's rolling. Let's just get it over with. Nobody gives a fuck about it anymore. It's just an obstruction.
Yeah, and Glow, I thankfully do not have Sebastian's case in my algorithm on TikTok, but I did hear about some guy. His name is like Jason or Justin, something like that. and I did see one of his videos, and he's got millions of subscribers, and the video I saw was him saying, I just wanted to clear up some misinformation that I shared with all of you. Because I have these sources that have never lied to me in the past, but they lied to me this time. Well, what sources? Who are they? And why would you just be repeating information not being vetted? It makes no sense. But alas, that's why some people are getting tens of thousands of views using this little boy's name.
Yeah. Well, I mean, just between us, like I feel more inspired and inclined to, you know, do something useful when I watch Unsupervised Maniacs videos and when I watch a Great Hughes live. I mean, 90% of these other channels are just fucking garbage. I mean, what the fuck? It's just entertainment. I don't want to make a missing child's case or worse type of case into entertainment. It's disturbing. And if you're giggling and telling jokes while you're, fuck that. Like, and this is not me trying to have, like, be a gatekeeper or control anything. I just think it's disgusting personally, to each their own, I suppose. But I'm not going to support it and pretend it's normal. Fucking, it's unhealthy for everyone involved.
And Cats and Kittens says, QB was pointing her finger at Dolly for judging the boy's mother while at the same time judging and insinuating the father as a grifter. Literally doing the same crap she just called Dolly out for. But, you know, the intent is different, right, Cats and Kittens? You know?
Well, it's that old hoodwink where you say, oh, this channel did something that was so terrible, and let me just play it unedited, just straight through exactly the same bad information that person broadcasts. They're just rebroadcasting it and pausing and laughing and talking about how horrible it is. They're still spreading the information, and they do it on purpose. It's not a whoopsies. Come on. I was bored at night, but not last night. They have no respect for, I mean, it's not about what's right. It's about what's right for them. And I see right through it, and boy, they don't like me for it. I tell you that.
Oh, and don't even get Sober Pug, don't even get me started on T-Rev. His thumbnails have also been disgusting. And then he has his spirit box crap. So normally when you use a spirit box, it's because you believe the person is deceased or, you know, a spirit. It's called a spirit box just for that reason. So by him doing these stupid spirit box things, lives, he's insinuating that Sebastian is no longer alive. Well, that's pretty gross in itself.
Yeah, I'm not with that.
Hey, Apple, how are you? Narcos, good to see you.
Because let's face it, this drama bullshit, it's for the fucking birds. It's entertaining a little bit. Like, some of it's fascinating, you know. They're just to see how they take a story and twist it up and lie and then present it in such a way where just people are like, that's the truth. That's fine. I mean, I'm not attempting to gain favor with any of those people whatsoever. So it's perfectly fine. I'm not losing subscribers to my channel. So I don't know what you're trying to do, but it's wild.
And Christy said, they all need to listen to Brandy last night. It's not about accusing or calling out. It's about the missing kid and sharing his info. Absolutely. That's what it's about is, you know, it's about Sebastian. And it's become not about Sebastian.
And it's the same characters doing the same shit, you know. But for some reason, it appears to be, to me, it just seems to be far more glaring, more explicit or something. You know, maybe I'm paying more attention now than I have in the past, but it just seems to be just an ugly thing. That's all.
Oh, and T-Rev has had a thumbnail with possible sighting for at least the last week. Yeah,
clickbait. I did see the thumbnail. I haven't watched.
And what I found interesting today is I heard someone say that another creator had sold their soul to get the views and the subs and everything. You know, they left their moral ground to grow their channel. And I thought, that's funny.
I can name 10 channels that fit that bill.
Because those of us who haven't sold ourselves out, for example, myself, are always being called out about, you know, we only have 23 people watching our lives or 10 people in our lives. Well, that's because we haven't sold our souls to the fucking devil. So, yeah, I could sell my soul to the devil, but that's not who I am. So make up your mind. Like, what is it? Would you rather someone take, you know, stay true to their morals? Or are you going to call out people for selling their soul to the devil?
That's a tough thing, huh? For me, it's like, okay, they've already gone through these attempts at canceling me and just completely defaming and misinforming people. Oh, that's the other thing. Burnt Toast had a live about me, I guess. Again, I was on a ghetto-ass train, B-Tim, with the other homeless people to take the train. Like, you are the most misinformed person I've ever heard speak. Like, it would serve you well to just shut your little bitch-ass mouth up. Like, you know, like a little bit of credit for using your big boy voice last night, but you're still a clown. Let there be no question about it. I lost my thought.
And Kit is here. Kit, you need to stop following me around. Although I did follow her. I followed her to her live because she was live after I was earlier. And but then she keeps following me. I love you, Kit. They don't like anyone talking back to them, LMAO. Like, they are the end-all be-all of YouTube. It's wild.
Yeah. I've said it before. They're running around trying to teach everybody rules to a game that nobody wants to play except for them. It's fucking pathetic. I've said the same thing. I'm not saying anything new. I've been consistent the entire time. And all they're doing is proving me right. So I've had it. Show me you're not a scumbag by being a scumbag. It's the weirdest shit ever. Guess what they're not talking about? I'll tell you what they're not talking about. Receipts. Like, you know, again, Becky, I'll show you the receipts. I'll show you my DD214. Come on over, but bring the receipts for payments to your lawyer along with the account balance for all the money you collected from people. Both of those, it should be readily available for you. We're not talking about that. We're talking about what we're talking about what I had for dinner on a train. On one of the most beautiful train lines in the whole entire country, right against the Pacific Ocean. You dummies. Like, what are you even thinking?
I thought maybe they thought you were, you know, riding the subway, which doesn't exist in California.
No, I wasn't with, the B-Tim rat people. I wasn't. I was riding the train down the coast of California.
But I've even taken a train to New York City because I don't remember who said it in chat, but it's easier than driving.
Why would I drive if I can read a book and
write
and draw? Like, what the fuck? I mean, what a pathetic life these people are leading if this is what they're left with, talking about what I ate for dinner. Every time I make a short video, it's for a very specific reason. They're like, oh, he's obsessed. Well, they fucking lie so much that every time I see some bullshit or hear some bullshit, I clip it and show it to everyone. So that's what it is. And the reason I do this is because I very much dislike people just blatantly lying constantly. I know personally what they can do to people. They've done it to me. They still are. I'll leave it in the videos because, like, I have to take this conversation offline because I have to handle it a different way, unfortunately, you know?
Yeah, trains to people in New York City are subways because, again, I've taken Amtrak from upstate to New York City. I've taken it, it's a day trip. I take the train down in the morning and then I take the train back home at night.
Oh, it's a beautiful trip. The one that I took, I actually took a shit ton of videos and photos. I'm going to put, I already have some together.
Coast Starlight. And that's the one you took, AMAC, right? When you came, when you went to California, Coast Starlight. Oh, and Sober Pug said, what did you have for dinner, sinner? Ha ha.
I had stuffed chicken. It was delicious.
Grandma Sherry says, sinner, did you eat Funyuns? Where did that come from?
I had no Funyuns. I don't know. I guess that's what they think poor people. The whole thing was.
Oh, right, because you live in a tent on the beach.
Yes, exactly.
You know, you have your little campfire singing Kumbaya.
Mm-hmm.
Your surfboard in the background.
It is quite fucking incredible, the character that they've created that's so far, you know, from who I actually am. But I mean, look, if I were them, I wouldn't like me either. Because I bring attention to how despicable they truly are. And that's dangerous to them, you know? So ultimately only God can judge them. Well, judges can judge them too, and they will. But all, you know, it's not about their money. Like, he keeps saying he's envious. No, ma'am. I'm not envious of the way you're making money whatsoever. I mean, I would wonder how you sleep at night, but that's also not my concern.
Ooh, Princess Wasp channel. Shelby Rains, that is a great way to describe that. Princess Wasp channel. Yes, a little bit. A little bit of that, a little bit of, you know, some other things. We're talking about apparently Funyuns now. The whole chat is abuzz with, oh, I didn't mean to use that play on words. Is all about Funyuns, which I do not like Funyuns.
I haven't had Funyuns in years.
No. No. Mm-mm.
I'll have some chicharrones every once in a while, though. Yeah, it's an Amtrak train, and it had, I can't even understand. Like, what did they do the last few days? Did they take the train down to Santa Barbara and sell a painting and say hello to a few friends and then take the train back home? What did they do? They sat there and talked about what I had for dinner. How pathetic. I mean, truly pathetic. All the while demanding proof that I was in the Marines. Like, on what authority, man? Would you, in what world would a Marine veteran feel obligated to show anything to a proven, documented, violent narcotic dealer who lets her fucking dogs run around the neighborhood? On what authority in what world do you think you're privy to any of my shit more than you've already collected and doxed? You're really sick, lady. I mean, honestly.
Grain said the dude said he had to sleep under a lean tube to earn his badge. I'm a need to see this merit badge. Lean tube, all confident like. I'm not sure.
I'm not sure I've ever slept in a lean tube, except for maybe boot camp. Okay, I don't understand. I'm never gonna show that crook any of my documents, like, for real. I mean, I totally will if she comes over with the account balance for how much money she collected for that legal fund, as well as her payments to her lawyer thus far. because I think there's something funny going on. I can't quite put my finger on it, but. Or is this just an inside joke? I'm confused. Lean to, like leaning against, lean to, it's like a half shelter, like a tent.
Yeah, Green. Has this fool ever been on a train with a drink car? Venture out a little. When
oh, an observation car is great too. It's like a glass car, so you can see everything.
I mean, I took a train when I was in when I went to South Africa in college. We took a train from Swaziland to Cape Town, and it was the longest train ride ever. But yeah, they have the drink car, the observation car, the dining car. You know, well, yeah, like I mean, people still take trains.
Well, that's the thing. Like the train that I took was about 10 hours each way. And if you get a sleeper car, all the meals are included. I didn't say I was staying at the Waldorf Astoria there, Timmy. I said I was on the train. I was eating dinner. What? How's that bother you so much? What's the matter, bud? Does that seem like an unbelievable story? And the only reason that came up is because I said that in Willow's chat. Because, of course, I was the topic of conversation for much of it. And had I not been on a train and surrounded by people, I would have blinked. I would have taken the link. So then he's like, apparently he's on a train eating with homeless people. He lives in a tent. Shut up, dude. Jesus Christ. Like, what is wrong with you? That's another way that I'll show my DD214. If Timmy comes and takes it, I'll hold it in my hand to wait for him. If he shows up, I'll let him look at it.
Yeah, exactly, Scorpio. Why they feel they are so important that anyone needs to show them shit? Why do people have to answer to them? Nobody has to answer to them.
I mean, they're actual crooks, proven. I mean, are you fucking kidding me? No way. I'm no angel, but I'm not asking for people's private documents. That's fucking weird that you think you're important enough in this world, let alone this community, to ask me for anything. You're out of your mind. Fuck, no ma'am, no ma'am.
Okay, so Grain said, instead of saying lean to, B-Tim said lean tube.
Oh, yeah.
Instead of a lean to, so again, shows, yeah. And I don't know how to pronounce words. Okay. Hey, Truth Seeker.
I mean, what a strange insult to lob at somebody. They're a homeless person. Ha, ha, ha. What the fuck? I mean, first of all, that's not true. Thank God. But I mean, what if it was true? Like, what the fuck? I mean, what a fucking bizarre thing to say to somebody. Truly.
Yeah, they don't even know what a train looks like. I mean, maybe they've never been on a train. They don't know. You know, obviously the train I take from, you know, upstate to New York City, there's not a dining car because it's only like an hour and a half trip. But I mean, people take the train all the time.
I enjoy it. I mean, I travel by train very often and I very much enjoy it. I don't give a fuck. I mean, most people I encounter on the train are smiling and polite, very much unlike what I deal with here on YouTube. So I recommend it to anyone. But I mean, the people criticizing a train ride down the coast with one of the most beautiful views in the entire fucking country. I mean, these same people don't go outside very much. They're creatures of the night, even in the day. So like, I get it. I understand their perspective, but it's so sad for them.
Right. And so V-Caser said, did they think you jumped on a boxcar, LOL? And then Grandma Sherry said, like hopped on a train hobo style?
Yeah, I don't know. No, they just want to paint this picture of me as like a homeless person, specifically Timmy, a little man child. I mean, I'm not above hopping a train if I needed to, but that wasn't the situation. Sorry, guys. I mean, they're making it so much more interesting than it actually is.
Okay, so he actually called Aileen Tube, then asked Lisa if she knew what one was. I'm not sure who Lisa is, but interesting.
Oh no, but I did find it interesting that one of those vampires were like, it's not like I looked up his train number or anything. Hey. And I thought to myself, why would you even say that you didn't do that? Like, these people are getting too wild, like too wild for me. Uh-uh. That's a hard pass. I mean, I said it very drunkenly on Thanksgiving, but if anybody comes to where I am, it's not going to be good for them. And that's there you go, get the sober version. It won't work out well for you.
Hey, Mr. Nobody. Mr. Nobody wants to know, did you ride the Coastal Express?
I don't remember. I don't think that was the line, no. I went from downtown Sacramento to Santa Barbara. Was it the Starlight? I can't remember. It was a big fucking train. It was packed full of people as well.
Yeah, right. Orion, apparently being unhoused is
Or
hilarious for
Starlight.
them.
Yeah, I don't understand why that would be funny, man. I like being a veteran. I know plenty of men and women that are veterans that battled with homelessness. So like that insult, whereas it's not true of me, it is true of a lot of good people. So I don't know. My expectations of their morals are very low, anyways. But that should even surprise me. It's like what a strange insult, like from someone who's panhandling on the internet, doesn't even have the courage to do it in real life. So, but don't
Yeah,
worry, guys.
right.
I'm housed and I'm doing just fine. So, thanks for the concern. I appreciate it. I don't know.
Scorpio. Scorpio's always got the best comments.
I didn't see it.
He said, B Tim sounded ignorant last night. How old are they? Wow, does he think he's so big and bad with all the cuss words while looking like Pee-wee?
Seriously, that's what I said. Like honestly, if he was saying something that was like important or possibly true or something that made sense, him using his big boy voice was pretty funny to hear. Like I was like, "You go, little buddy, you tell him." But it was all complete bullshit. He's telling me what I should do and what I shouldn't do, calling me names. That little nerd, like, go sit down, Timmy. Really. You don't have their credentials to even talk like you're talking about me, boy. Uh-uh. No, ma'am.
Oh, wow, Glow, 8 hours from Vermont to Connecticut because of all the stops.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. A lot of them need to get outside for sure. I mean, I've proven documentation that I've been outside. What do you, let's see your proof, guys. Let's see your community post of going for a walk in the garden, Becky. Oh, you won't be out there because you can't count that money out there, huh? Gross.
And I just want to specify, we're talking about giving back to our real life community, not the YouTube community. There was a comment I'll share with you later, Sinner, that
Oh yeah.
you probably
What
saw
you
it.
what community what is this that you call this community?
Well, because someone in chat had said she's always giving back to her community, not her real
Don't
life community.
go sell that somewhere else. Get the fuck out of here. But that's simply not true. I know better, so nice try. Many people know better. even the people around her, even the people sitting right over next to her on her panels that message me know that she's doing wrong right now. So there is that. Stay tuned.
Yeah, Remy, I know. Rent is outrageous. Interest rates are, housing prices. I mean, everything is going up. Oh, Glow with Glow. When we were thinking about this live, we actually were thinking about calling it Happy Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
Because, you know, they seem to, you know, I mean, Thanksgiving is a great holiday.
I actually listened to that whole live again, and it's not, it's sort of a nothing burger, to be honest. They exaggerated. I think the main drama in the stream was the fact that Emmy decided to boot me because I was arguing with someone in chat, which is, you know, I respect that. It was her channel that we were on. So, but that's what caused the drama, and that's what brought it attention. What I actually said wasn't that bad. The message that I was trying to relay is if someone hurts my friend, I'm going to hurt them. And I guess that wasn't, you know, it's not proper for these cowards to hear such words because they feel like they're protected by this whole YouTube thing or whatever. But all I was saying is if someone shows up to your house, Emmy, fuck them up if you have to. And I stand by that. I understand it's difficult for you actual cowards to understand that, but that's what it is. That's what I was trying to say. And I did a bad job at it, but hopefully that clarifies it for you.
And Remy said, I know a creator who has used 100% of her channel proceeds to help her unhoused friends. She has usually a wish list for items like non-perishables, tents, sleeping bags, etc. That's amazing. That really is amazing.
I know a few people who do that as well. Like it's yeah, I think more people should. I mean, it would serve people better to, you know, help than to use it as an insult against somebody, whether it be true or not. It's still, you're still putting those words out there like a sicko, like you're sitting over there like fucking like the Gestapo. Is this World War II? You're demanding people's papers and you're dictating what people can say or what they can't say. And then you say, I'm against free speech. I mean, the irony is in that is astounding to me. That's how I know you're just a complete fucking idiot. The second I won this whole argument against you dumbasses is whenever you started making stuff up. I mean, I don't think you realize yet, but you already lost the argument.
Yeah, and Glow, karma will come around.
Oh, yes, it will. Mark my words. Like I said weeks ago, I'm not resting until he is held accountable for what he's done to me. And I mean that. I know it sounds like he's trying to change the world. No, no. Specifically, one person defamed me, and she will be held accountable. Mark my words.
Oh, Narcos says, oh, people think you're a woman because of how you speak? That's kind of like they thought, wasn't it Mr. Nobody they thought was a female as well because AMAC said, girl. Girl. Kit Kat, that comment about giving back was not sarcasm because they did comment again. And they added on to that statement saying that that they even stick up for victims' families against the tragedy pimps.
Oh my God, you can completely go suck it with that because we know better than that over here. Nice try.
Yeah, AMAC. Your propaganda. AMAC is bringing the smack down today.
That is no, no, no. We know that's not true. Nice try. Mm-mm. Negative Ghost Rider, the fucking pattern is full.
I had Benihana for Thanksgiving. I would love to have that again. What is Benny? Is it Benihana?
Yeah, the
I've
restaurant.
never heard of that.
Asian fusion. It's a chain, but it's pretty fucking good. But if I say that, then people are going to say homeless people eat Benihana. Fucking weirdos. Also, the disturbing thing. Okay, first of all, I'm not an incel. It's funny you say that. But you, it's cool if you believe it. But I mean, it's not true. But the same people also call me abusive to women and bad to women. Do they know what an incel is? Because those two things are mutually exclusive. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that was a little
It's
weird when you told me
one or the
about what
other,
was
but it's
said.
really neither. It's like one or the other, but it's really neither. But I do have an antidote here, something funny. Like Queen Bee said in her live that she thinks I secretly want to sleep with her. That's one of the most revolting things I've ever heard in my life. In fact, I told Emmy when I heard that, I was like, I think I honestly would rather lose a finger. I'm not sure which finger, but I would rather lose a finger than be intimate with such a despicable human being. That's just the facts. But the irony in it is, I'm pretty sure that if I were to do that, that's how incels are made. Probably not want anything to do with women ever again after that.
So then she'd be responsible for you being an incel.
That's what I'm saying. I think that's how they're made. Yeah, from women like her,
Oh, so
like a factory.
makes sense.
So
And
no,
Remy, I don't know if you saw
again.
Remy's comment center. She said, "Thanksgiving wasn't exactly your finest night. However, something positive came out of it. You have chosen to abstain from alcohol, and that's commendable."
Yeah, I mean, of course they're saying that's not true. I mean,
Oh yeah, they say it
Thanksgiving.
all the time. Oh yeah, there's no way he's not drinking. He sounds exactly the same. No, he doesn't.
It's
And
just slander.
I
It's
will.
just complete slander. It's all it is. You know, it's cool. Again, they're really some of the worst people on YouTube. So why would I expect anything more from them? I mean, they're actual legit pieces of shit.
And someone in chat asked, what if you got drunk on Thanksgiving and said some things? What's their excuse when they do it every day?
Every day, 4 days a week. 4 days a week. And it's like that's whatever. I don't really care about much of that except for the specific shit that she's done to me. That's my concern. The rest of it, have fun. Have fun talking about my art. I like my art. The people that buy my paintings like my art, so that's my concern. Not YouTube welfare recipients can, you know, your opinions don't can concern or affect that. So thankfully, I'm self-employed, so you can't call my boss and do all that other weird shit that you do to everyone else. So that must be frustrating for you.
And someone had said,
Wow,
where's that comment?
Remy said they've been sober for 12 years. That's awesome. Yeah, I mean, I never, and again, I never made a proclamation that I'm a poster boy for sobriety. So if I drink tomorrow, that's also none of their business. But you know, if I do, I'm not going to lie and say I haven't. So they can just, again, they could suck it. Why they, I mean, they're concerned with what I had for dinner. Of course, they're going to be saying I drink.
And Jenny says, some of us are banned over there. So much for free speech. It's YouTube, anyways. I won't complain how you mod if you don't complain about how others mod. Yeah, Jenny, I saw you were causing some waves
Oh, I mean, just
yesterday.
the projection of saying that I support cancel culture. Meanwhile, that's what they're doing is attempting to cancel me. Attempting. And that's the operative word.
And yesterday I did catch just a little bit of Bee's Live, and someone tried to go on panel because, it's an open panel. And she said, "Oh no,
Open
not
channel.
right now, baby, not right now." Well,
They were triggered, huh? Jeez.
isn't that the point? Shouldn't anyone be able to? And I don't remember who it was. I think it was, anyways, it doesn't matter. They tried to go on panel and she would not allow them on panel. She said, "Email me." Well, then that's not an open panel.
No,
That's,
it's a
I'll open
dump
it up
pool.
when it's right for, the conversation.
In my mind, it's just like, imagine you walk into your bathroom and your bathtub's just full of turds, just floating. That's how I imagine the hive, straight up. And I always felt that way, and I kind of regret not saying so earlier. But this is where we are now. Now I have a specific, they just proved me right by what they're attempting to do to me. Everything I've been saying about them, they just did it to me. So now I have a prime example of how disgusting they are.
And I
They're
agree,
a bunch of
Fletcher. The word tragedy pimp is played the F out, especially when you have whoever calling it out all the while collecting Cash Apps, PayPal, memberships, in my opinion. Right.
I mean, specifically the Hive, they don't call anything out. Like whenever those allegations, I mean, whenever some crazy allegation is made by a shitty channel, they just replay it. The slightest mindless commentary with the host gone for 90% of it. It's absolutely pathetic, to come 3 seconds after finishing a press conference about a missing or a deceased child, they're talking shit on somebody that has nothing to do with anything. Like trying to associate their own personal bullshit with the missing child case, like by putting it in such close proximity. It's truly disturbing.
That's a good word, Scorpio,
Oh no.
flingy.
Oh no, I'm not going on anybody's panel that's has been saying such crazy things about me. That's never gonna happen. No, ma'am. And they're not welcome on, on my lives either. I'll be here live solo very soon, so they're not welcome there. Fuck all of them. That's not what I'm doing. I'm pointing out truth. I'm not having a little pissing contest with people that aren't very smart.
They have to stay with the script, no surprises. Good point.
Yeah, and then they came to the end of the script, so they just went right back to the beginning with, "Oh, he's lying about being a Marine." No, ma'am. No, ma'am. Nice try.
And the one, there is one thing I want to say, because I get you and B have, you're calling each other by first names. I don't agree with it. That's one thing we have disagreed on. But I know you're going to be streaming us, B. So I don't call you by your first name because, again, I don't agree with it. Can you please stop referring to me as mine? Just because Sinner calls you by your legal name doesn't mean you can do it to me. I give you that respect because I don't think it's appropriate. So please stop using my name in comments and, on lives because
She
I
can't.
don't do it to
She,
you.
well, she's incapable of refraining from the actions that actually got her sued to begin with. Does everyone just forget that?
I've
The
never
Hive?
said her first name ever.
No,
And the
well, the
fact that
thing is,
she's consistently saying mine,
I said
that's
it in retaliation to her saying mine.
pretty messed up.
Yeah, the shit between me and her is completely different. She wants to put it together. I mean, trust me, I would have called her out a long time ago. This whole lawsuit, nobody ever cared about it from the beginning. And the people I get down with, like she, I again, she's the center of her universe, and she has it fucked up like she's the center of the universe. Those are two different things, lady. So different. And just using Emmy's first name over and over again—that's just to get at me, because she's a pathetic bitch. Let's face it.
And for what? Like I go by Emmy. Like I call you B. I mean, I just don't, put the queen in front of it. But I've never called her by her legal first name ever. And if I have, please show me, because I honestly do not remember, but I've never said your legal name, so please stop using mine.
Yeah, I said, I mean, I'm not going on anyone's panel. I would debate Queen Bee about anything, really anything. Like, I would love to have a debate to her about, I'm sorry, I would love to have a debate with her about what a tragedy pimp is. Because I have an opinion about what it is. I think she fits into that category.
Yeah, Remy, I don't like the first name stuff. I mean, and I mean, you
Well,
know,
neither do I, but
even
let's face
Betty,
it.
I've never called
She
Betty by her first name ever. She's always been, well, I called her Betty and Bertha,
Listen,
and she said to stop saying her name.
whenever QB was doxing my name on her channel out of anger, I was just a sub in this community. I didn't even have a channel. I didn't make one video. I wasn't associated. It was all complete bullshit. She came at just a regular sub, right? You're not supposed to do that. Every rule that she says that she stands for, she does the exact opposite. Very much like Pimmy Boy over there calling, saying I'm against freedom of speech. Meanwhile, the whole problem with what they're trying to get rid of me for is things that I've said. That speech, you dumb little boy. How do you get it so wrong? I support free speech so much that I decided to join the military to defend our country. What have you done, Timmy? You're defending a fraud ass lawsuit. That's what you're defending. I signed up to defend the country, and you signed up to defend a hive. And you think you're better than me. You're a fucking nobody.
And I just saw SoFlo's comment. So SoFlo had said something about a horse face. So I just have, I know JP may be listening. Well, she will be probably watching later when they, you know, stream us on Rumble. But there used to be, this was months ago, there was someone that would sit on their couch with a horse mask on. And it was always in relation to Laura. And I want to know, JP, are you the person who had the horse mask on and went on panels? It just, I don't know. It just clicked one day that maybe that was you.
I
You
never
know,
heard of
you can let me know in a comment where, you know,
that.
somewhere.
Oh yes, this is what I will say about JP. She was cute the other day and was like, "Oh, let's not go by first names," and then she used my first name anyways. I'm not gonna stoop though, because she was like, "Oops, I read a comment. I was just a comment. I didn't actually say
And
it." Yes, she
the
did.
thing
I,
is,
but no, I do have one other specific thing to say, because I'm not concerned about her opinion of me so much. I mean, it would be better if she was funny, but she's not. But what I don't appreciate is her saying, "My husband's a military veteran, and he says the first thing you would do is just show your documentation." No, ma'am. No, ma'am. What's right for your husband is not necessarily what's right for me. That's number one. Number two is, if your husband is married to you, I wouldn't take any recommendations from him whatsoever. So just the idea that he would so quickly show a fucking proven convict, drug dealing, violent person, his private documentation to prove something. Again, no, ma'am. That's a no-no. That's not going to happen.
all right, and everyone actually answered my question in chat, so JP, you're off the hook. She was definitely not the horse mask. So people in chat must know who it is. I just thought maybe that was her. But thank you for answering my question, so JP doesn't have to.
I hope I cleared that up for them, because I mean, let the conspiracy grow, but they're not getting shit from me. I think it's cute that they even consider asking me for anything like that. It's fucking bizarre. You
Hey,
hear that?
Chain.
KB Investigates. KB Investigates left the ugliest comment last night in one of my videos. I'm gonna prove that you didn't serve this country, and I have the resources to do so. That's a weird threat, man. I can save you the footwork. I did, in fact, serve in the Marines. I do, in fact, have an honorable discharge, and I am very much proud of it. So good luck with your fucking sleuthing, genius.
Oh, Ninja, I agree. Doing fuck shit on Rumble is not saying it with your chest.
No, I mean, she was on a timeout for being a shitty YouTuber, and of course, you've got to do something to go over there with 119 people and make jokes about going, once again, going to somebody's real life. I don't think JP realizes the person that she was talking to with that inside joke is someone that actually sends people to people's homes. That's a documented fact. So that's why I made a short about it. Because even I look, do I think that she was going to come to where I live? Not so much. But I wanted to show the fact that they're having an inside joke about sending someone to someone's house. I mean, with a person that does that shit, goes real life on people. And I'm talking about QB in case there's any confusion. So good luck with that situation, JP. I'm not sure if you know what you're in for.
Yeah, that's true, Christy. They have no right to information regarding employment. Very strange ask. Do they plan on showing their tax info to you?
Oh, I'd be satisfied with the account balance for that law fund, the legal fund, as well as the receipts for the amount that's already been paid to her lawyer. I mean, she knows those numbers should be right there. Boom, boom. The clack, clack. Like, what's the problem? I know what the problem is. Something's wrong. I think something's wrong.
And just a reminder, if you haven't done your taxes, TikTok people, you just got a couple of days left.
Yeah, you could do your taxes right on your Cash App.
Hey, Hippie. Oh, Hippie said she saw the hashtag Cash Cow as well. Yeah, AMAC, thank you so much.
It didn't fit in there. I mean, I sent you a picture of it, didn't I?
Yeah, I think you did.
Yeah, we should look at that. We should look at that because I'm very confused about that.
That was yesterday, I think, right? Or was it today?
I think it was yesterday, yeah. It would be cool if you could show that. Because, I mean, I was here, but I saw it. I was like, well, hold on a second. I was going to make a video about it, but I wanted some clarification. I thought maybe she can explain it. Hey, Hippie, how's it going?
Oh, I have it. Here it is.
Sorry if I didn't say hi to everyone. It's like I said, I pace around often when I'm live.
All right, you want me to show it? I have it here.
Yeah, might as well.
Oh, wrong button. Oops.
Oh, it's giant.
I think I can make it small. Oh, there we go.
Like, look at all the other hashtags are legit. And then Cash Cow? Say what now? Like, what the actual fuck?
Oh, right. And there's the parents as well.
I mean, I'm a pretty rational person, but why you got Cash Cow written in there in this missing child case? Exactly. I'm going to criticize that because I think that's sick. I think that's out of place.
Oh, and I just, Christy, actually, I didn't notice. Christy said, what a pretty bikini.
Oh, I guess. Good call. No flow's ready.
Yep. So flow's ready. SoFlo will be with her bikini and her pool noodle.
I mean, correct me in chat. Is it normal to put Cash Cow like that under a missing child? And then I'm sure that stream was, she was shit talking shit on people anyway. So that's also weird. But the hashtag thing was like, okay, whoa.
Who is Sticky? Scorpio said, Sticky, did you file your taxes? I don't know who Sticky is. Oh, good. Just Jake has their taxes done. They got them done today. Shelby starts hers in December. Yeah, I got mine done actually pretty early this year.
I feel like there's something I'm forgetting. Oh, yes. Burnt Toast Live. Again, I'm not whatsoever surprised that someone with such close association with someone I despise has, you know, a bad opinion of me. I always knew that to be true. For some reason, I imagined that we wouldn't like argue with each other, because, you know, I'm pretty sure we both think we're right. So what's the sense? But in any case, the big gotcha moment that she had about the VA not having whatever services she was talking, that's all for nothing. She wasted all of her breath there, because that's not what I said. I didn't say I went to the VA for free legal service, you dummies. I don't understand how you can't get anything right, you guys. Seriously, what are you doing? What I said was that I went to an organization that offers pro bono legal advice for veterans. Why is that hard for you to understand?
And the right, city you never said the VA, correct?
No, we talked about the VA after that. They convoluted them. They're not very smart.
Oh, yes, and the tree mill.
I think what they're doing is trying to get me to say, oh, this is the place that I went, so they can call and harass them because they're sick fucks. So I'm not going to be doing that. But I mean, rest assured that I'm fully aware of what services are available to me from the VA, as well as from, you know, nonprofit organizations that also support, you know, Marine Corps veterans. So nice try, guys, but it's goofy that you think like you would know better than I know what's happening here with me. So, and they did offer me great legal advice, which is one of the reasons that I should probably take most of this off of line. So, but we'll see.
A lot of people not wearing bikinis. Some people are.
It's almost bikini season.
Right. And I guess the treadmill was supposed to be treadmill, but SoFlo was typing fast. So they're like, what's a treadmill?
Oh, I missed that.
Yeah, that was the live the other. Yesterday it was.
Oh, them. Yeah, they're just fucking.
Well, no, happy. Not B, PJ, because SoFlo had said meant to say treadmill, but it came out tree mill. So they talked about what is a tree mill for like 5 minutes, and people in chat were saying she meant treadmill.
Yeah, I mean, I really don't know exactly what these people want from me. If they want me to show my papers like it's World War II, they're mistaken.
I would never do that.
It's never going to happen. I'm a fucking devout patriotic person. Like I fucking love this country and every single right that we have. If they think they can infringe upon my privacy any more than they already have insisted on doing, they are sadly fucking mistaken. I mean, if they think they can take it from me, they can try to get it.
Oh, today she woke up thinking about you, so Flo.
Did I have a bikini on? Didn't. Yeah, it's been a strange couple of days. I mean, they're going hard. I mean, they're so triggered. Like, about what? Are they nervous about their court case? Like, cue the people's court music. No one gives a shit.
I mean, Betty did mention that she is driving to Illinois after apparently she was supposed to be harassing Sebastian's mom and stepdad in Mississippi. And then from Mississippi, she was driving up to Illinois. And then she was going to drive to Tennessee after that.
Yeah. Well, I've been in trouble, and I think it's always good to show up to your court cases. In person, if that's what they're asking for, just do what they want and fucking do your best to plead your case. I hope they both stub their toe in the morning when they wake up to go to court and it hurts all day. That's what I hope. And I hope the judge says, hey, this is what we should do. We should handcuff these two fucking knuckleheads together for a month, like, and make like a buddy film, because that's how seriously we should be taking this. Like, it was a big lie when they were like, this is going to set precedent, and this is going to protect other YouTubers from other YouTubers doing such terrible things. Listen to how funny that is now that we see the person being Queen Bee is doing the same exact thing and supported by the same people that said they were against it to begin with. Except now she's doing it to me. Nice fucking try. Like, I don't understand. You really think that I'm that dumb? Don't answer. That's fine with me. I being underestimated is a very powerful position to be in.
Yeah, they're going to be in the same room, I guess, Scorpio. Good question, Christy. Good question.
Hopefully, can we stream that shit? Hopefully we can stream that shit.
No, you can't stream it.
Damn it.
You can watch it, but you can't stream it or record it. That's illegal.
Oh, is it? Well, I don't know. It's different everywhere.
Who's going to pay Betty when she wins?
I don't think. Well, look, they both lost already if they haven't noticed.
Well, and I will say, you know, Betty is claiming financial hardship. And
that's true.
She's gained almost 2,000 subs on her main channel. And her videos are getting over 5,000 views.
Yeah, I don't watch. I don't.
So honestly, she should have waited a little bit before.
I've been accused of like being Team Betty or whatever. That's simply not true. And I think anyone that knows me for shit knows that's not true. I don't focus on Betty because she's not the one that's doxing me and lying about me. If she was, I would be squarely focused on her. She seems busy, you know, misinforming about stories without me having to criticize her. Like, what am I going to do by gaining in that? I'm simply defending myself against a bunch of bullshit from the Hive. Like, that in no way makes me Team Betty, so stop it with that shit.
I agree with you, Trutex, and I think he's going to throw all of it out. But then again, you never know.
I say handcuff those knuckleheads together and make a buddy film. Like Weekend at Bernie's.
Oh, Christy says if Betty loses, she won't have to pay. Florida has protections against losing assets to civil suits. She will keep her house and car.
Yeah, they don't take the house. They can't take, you know. There is limitations to that. If you live in a mansion, it can definitely take the mansion and allot you with enough to provide housing for yourself.
And Scorpio says, does that include stuff that has happened after the case started or just before? It's my opinion, it should only be what the initial complaint was. It shouldn't have, you know, well, but if she's claiming financial hardship, she's not in financial hardship anymore. Her channel isn't dying. It's actually growing.
Well, I mean, we would be talking about two completely different cases if we, like, what occurred at the time of the lawsuit and what's occurred since then. Like, those would be two completely different cases. I don't think the QB would even win if Betty were allowed to include everything that's happened to this date instead of, like, when it was filed.
Right, but I think, well, Betty's been throwing stuff in, you know, that's happened after she initially filed it, which I don't think is appropriate because that's not what the claim was.
I don't think it is either. I mean, I understand why she would want to do that because it does bolster her case quite a fucking bit. Let's keep it a buck.
But it's not relevant to what her initial.
Yeah, it shouldn't be. It shouldn't be included. But you understand the inclination to try to do what you got to do to win, right? So, I mean, They'll battle it out. Hopefully, like the judge will just have some common sense. Hopefully, he's a fan of YouTube paying attention. That'll be real cool.
Oh, and that's actually a good point too. B has laid off BHB so she can show that her channel will grow if left alone. Yeah, I never thought of it that way.
Yeah, I mean, just because I have a legitimate gripe with UB doesn't mean that I automatically am in some weird alliance with someone. She's in a fucking dumbass lawsuit that I don't give a fuck about anyways. Like, it's bad logic, you guys. Like, fuck. I never claim to be a, even above average intellect, but I'm smarter than that. Like, it's fucking common sense.
She should be able to take a hardship loan through the YouTube 401k.
I love that.
Yeah, if
That is
only.
fucking great. I love it. But yeah, the buck's gonna stop here. Like, I mean, if I have to martyr myself and be an example, I'll fucking do it. I don't give a fuck. And again, they're like, oh, Sinner said he's acting like he's trying to change the world. I know it's as cheesy as it is. Like, well, what are you doing? I can't even take a fucking train trip without you calling me homeless and stupid. It really makes you guys look fucking pathetic, man. I already won the argument when you start doing that.
Yeah, true Jedi forever. It's growing because YouTube continues to allow worse and worse behavior to be monetized. And I almost feel like all of these creators who are now exploiting Sebastian, they have like some kind of secret group where they just have all of their subs go to the next person. So it's kind of like, let's just all share subs so all of us can grow while we exploit this poor little kid.
It's fucking disgusting. I honestly haven't been paying that much attention. Man, I tuned into Nundius yesterday and I was not fucking prepared for that. I don't know if you guys caught that.
I did not.
It was difficult to watch, but I mean, it was, completely vital.
But I believe it was about Amethyst Moon, and I had watched Nonsense had done a couple of lives, I think, where she had Amethyst on to talk about her case, and definitely powerful, definitely powerful.
Well, it gave me perspective. I mean, whereas like it's all this drama stuff seems like it holds any kind of value. It really doesn't. It doesn't fucking matter. All we're doing is tearing each other apart. I'm just on the losing end of it at the moment. Of course I'm bitter. It's, again, it's easy for us to feel like we're the center of the universe when we're just the center of our own, nothing more. So, as where it was difficult to watch and hear that story, it also made me realize that there's way more important things going on, looking out for victims and actually wanting to help missing and missing children cases. It's like, what are we doing fighting with each other about what we have for dinner? Like, just stop defaming me and just cut the bullshit. Be done with it. Fuck.
Right, because it to me, it seems like there are more important things to be fighting for. For example, Amethyst case. Her offender is up for parole. That's pretty important.
Yeah, it's a terrifying story. I mean, it stuck with me since I watched it, and even waking up and all day today, it stuck with me.
And then I did see a comment someone sent to me. Someone commented on, I don't know if it was Nunya's live or on something Nonsense had done in
Yeah,
regards to Amethyst,
no,
but
somebody did come in there and they were despicable
they
in the comment.
said, I would something like, I would support this, but I don't like this person who's presenting the story. Who fucking cares? Like, who cares if you like the person or not? The story is what's important. Like, how can you, if you don't have to like someone, but you can support good that they're doing. And to have to state that in a comment, grow up.
Yeah, I caught some of nonsense. I mean, I don't watch her often. I don't know exactly what she's about. It seems to me when I turn her on, she's usually on point, and I don't disagree with what she's saying, so I listen sometimes. I don't comment because I don't know what politically, if I would be chased out of there or whatever, but she often has good things to say. But she commented on the person coming into Nunez. I caught that pretty good. And as strange as it would be for me, or as it is for me to say this, I agree with her that, you know, all this drama and all this bullshit doesn't help anybody.
I mean, it helps people get views and clicks.
Well, but I mean, no, but it doesn't legitimately help any.
Oh no, it doesn't help the greater good.
It doesn't help any missing children. It doesn't help anything. It's not. It's not for. It's not what's right. It's what's right for these, you know, greedy people.
Right.
And it made me feel like shit because, like, some of the things that she was saying, like, I clearly fit into what she was talking negatively about. So, and I don't want to do that. I don't want to continue to just be that. So I'm not going to give it to them anymore. I mean, of course, they're never going to stop. And I'm still going to make my clips. So, and then when I go live, of course, I'll be talking about them because they're never going to stop. So you have to reply to them occasionally. But I'm not going to give them anywhere near what they want. No, ma'am. Sorry. You're not worth it anymore. Now regurgitating the same stories that you came at me with the first time. It's old. Beat.
Okay, so the parole board hearing for Amethyst's attacker is not open to the public.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to watch that. Anyways, fuck.
I hope the parole board makes the right decision and keeps his ass in prison.
I mean, I can't even imagine. Remy says, well, Sinner, since the hearing for Amethyst is in Cali next week, got any plans? I do have some things to do next week, and I would feel like I'm so uncomfortable going to see that. I mean, I guess it would be interesting, but I don't think I'm that guy. I can go and protest, Remy says. Yeah, imagine that.
I mean, and anybody can write a letter to the parole board. I mean, that's what people, you know, I know Nonsense did. Nanya did a video. But, like, that's what people, that's true advocacy. Send a letter to the parole board saying why this monster shouldn't be paroled.
Well, I mean, Remy actually has a point. That would be something worthy of protesting. You know, if you can protest in a point where you're not going to impede people's movements around you. And, I mean, hopefully the people making the judgment are able to see that you're protesting. I don't know, you know, it's not something I could do. And with the fucking position I am with these fucking people, if I go out protesting, they're just going to make more money off of me. No, thank you. I can, if I'm going to do any good things in this community, I can do it in silence. I don't have to walk around tooting my own horn like those people do.
Right. Like going to a campground with your bullhorn to harass and berate a mom and stepdad of a missing child. Like, what is that going to do to help find this little boy? Absolutely nothing. Nothing.
Yeah. Yeah. And then it just, the grift just ripples because then everyone covering it also is making money from it too. So it's this big wave of income from just regurgitating really negative shit. I mean, it's clear as day to me.
Did that supposed public, what was it, rebuking actually happen? In regards to BHB, Remy, not that I saw. The last live, well, actually, I noticed that BHB has been doing lives on TikTok and then recording those lives and then just posting them as premieres on YouTube. But the last live she did was in her car.
I thought that you couldn't do that. I thought this,
I don't know, but that's what she's doing.
What the? I mean, I don't really see anything wrong with that. But I thought there was like some type of.
I mean, I do the same thing. The shorts that I upload to TikTok, I upload to YouTube. But I don't record on TikTok and then post it on YouTube.
Well, what was the repetitive content thing about then?
Oh, reused content?
Yeah, I thought that was like something detecting that you had already posted it on TikTok. And
I think it was because I think that's more along the lines of people. Or no, actually, yeah, like I would be talking about the same thing. I don't really know.
Because I know YouTube and Twitter do not work well together. They're not compadres, so to speak. So I thought that reason that you had trouble was because something detected, oh, they had posted this to Twitter already. So Twitter has some weird, not ownership, but control over it, where it can't be posted on YouTube as well. That's what I thought that was about. I mean, I understood wrong.
And I will actually share if any of you have TikTok, I will share my TikTok link. I try to post at least once a day, but it doesn't always happen. But I do post the same shorts on YouTube. It's just a lot shorter because YouTube only allows up to 60 seconds, whereas TikTok allows up to 10 minutes. So I wish YouTube would, you know, just up it by like 30 seconds. But I have to cut stuff out on YouTube, unfortunately.
I saw your question. I mean, you play whatever you'd like. I mean, I am taking the thing over here.
Oh, well, it's kind of, we kind of moved on from that topic. Oh, so,
okay.
Kit says, I put my TikTok on my YouTube shorts. However, I have to change the songs. It's weird how they're different that way. Yeah, you can use some songs on TikTok without copyright, but then if you put it on YouTube, you get copyright. So it's like TikTok pays for the license to use.
Exactly.
Or I don't know if, Kit, if you've had this happen. Do you remember when Baby Halo, we had the Amber Alert, and I was out to lunch with my family, and so we had the Amber Alert for Baby Halo, and so I posted a short really quick, and Sinner's trying to get a hold of me. I'm not looking at my phone. Apparently TikTok just attaches songs to your shorts without you knowing.
Terrible.
And it was a horrific song.
Yeah,
so I'm like, oh my God, what the heck? Same thing happened to my sister when she posted it on TikTok. So
I mean, it was shocking. It was like some song about, I can't even, I'm not even saying it. It was just so inappropriate for like a missing child case. I was like, I pressed play because of course I watch Emmy's stuff. And I'm just like, what the fuck is happening right now?
Yep. And like, it kept doing it over and over. I'm like, all right, TikTok, get it together. I don't want a song on my video. Especially, oh, really, Kit? It happened to you about OJ? Oh, no. Well, hopefully it was a fitting song for OJ.
Oh, we have one less fucking murder in the world. Imagine that. I mean, it's a good day.
Yeah, Remy. Yep, 4 arrests in the case of the Oklahoma moms. And I did do a short on the 2 moms last week, so I'm going to have to look into that later today and see. I'll probably, well, I have two shorts that I'm still working on, but and I'm still following the Sydney Mall incident where six people lost their lives and several others were injured.
Oh, that's clever, Remy. OJ can rest easy knowing his wife's killer has passed away. People are saying good luck to Glow. I missed what happened. What'd you say?
Let me see. I must have missed it too. Oh, here it is. I get my suspicious mole checked out on Tuesday. Oh no, Glow. I hope
Oh
it's
yeah, I
like
saw
Remy
that
said, I hope
video.
it's just suspicious and nothing more.
In any case, getting it checked out is the most important thing. I know I saw that a while ago. She'd been discussing that on a video on her channel. And I was really bothered. I was like, shit, you have to get in sooner. But I guess sometimes the ball just rolls slow when it comes to appointments.
Sure
But
does.
my advice, anytime anybody's going to get a procedure and they're not feeling well, I'm like, fuck, you need a closer date. That's always my advice. And I've been blessed with pretty good health, so I haven't had to wait on appointments like that too often.
Yeah, and if you want an immediate appointment, that's go to the ER. Unfortunately. Or
Yeah,
urgent care, and they'll send you to ER.
I've been to urgent care with skateboarding injuries. Yeah, skateboarding, bruh. Like that for some reason that it triggers them that I surf as well. Just because they get out of breath like going to the bathroom doesn't mean that I can't enjoy my life.
Yes, Sober Pug. She's been wearing, I just think of like a PJ top, like a pajama top. It's so bizarre. It's weird, like a cami.
Hey, what's up, Willow? Willow's in the house.
Someone else in our community has a suspicious mole. Can't recall who.
Her
I'm sure it'll
grandma.
come to me.
Oh my God, grandma. That's hilarious. Okay, that's good. That made me laugh genuinely. That's
Might have to laser that right out.
But no, not to make light of it. I hope the appointment goes well and
Oh,
it's
I
not that
know. Glow said it looks real bad. I'm preparing for the worst. Well, I hope that it's the best. I mean, it's always good to prepare for the worst. And that way although I don't think we can ever be prepared, but knowing that, thinking about what could be the worst and then having it not be as bad is a little bit easier, I think, to
bad.
take. And hopefully it's just suspicious.
A small round small round cheese block asked me, do you snowboard? No, I haven't. Well, no, I mean, I don't. I have gone, but a couple of times that I went snowboarding, I was drinking very much and spent most of the time in the lodge hanging out with friends, drinking, playing pool, and doing things like that. I actually not too good at snowboarding. I've skied a lot more.
Speaking of pool, someone had told Willow he probably should laser that out. And Willow said laser removal, probably gonna need a PayPal pool. Lots of PayPal pools.
It's
Hey,
so fucking
Lisa.
pathetic, like, but if she wants to share all the, her receipts, I'll share my discharge papers for my Marine Corps service, my honorable Marine Corps service that I'm very proud of. I'll gladly show her, just her, if she comes with those receipts. Oh, shout. Like, I'll do it today. I'll do it right now. That sounds like a fair deal, doesn't
I wouldn't show shit. That's just my opinion.
No, I'm just so confident that she's shady as hell and she's not going to show anybody that shit. I mean, how do you, I mean, I don't know. What does it mean to launder money again? I heard somebody say, what is it, laundering? I'm like, I'm not sure what that is.
I mean, isn't it when you take money for one cause, but like Alex Murdaugh, wasn't he laundering money? He was getting money for civil suits and then taking it for himself.
Yeah, I think so. I don't know. To me, it seems like there's some shenanigans because the official story at the beginning was like, I'm going to be taking care of this and everyone will know exactly where every penny. Now that's gone and that's no longer true. Nobody wants to take
any. Okay, so definitely not money laundering, because that money laundering is when the criminal transforms the monetary proceeds derived from criminal activity into funds with an apparently legal source. So I actually was thinking of it backwards.
Okay, so if a channel was, let's say, making buckets of money illegally and then super chatting or buying a bunch of memberships on their own channel, that would be money laundering.
Well, not necessarily, because it also says money laundering is the process of illegally concealing the origin of money obtained from illicit activities such as drug trafficking, corruption.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Somebody's like taking a bunch of illegal money and buying themselves a bunch of memberships on one of their live streams. That would be money laundering. If there was ill-gotten money to begin with, if they received...
Right, so if a criminal... Say a criminal...
Gotcha.
A criminal came here and bought... say they were a bank robber, right? And they used the stolen money to gift memberships. That would be money laundering.
Or a drug dealer. Drug dealers need to launder their money too. But I mean, I don't think you would launder money on it through super chats or buying memberships, because you would lose 30%. That would be quite a significant loss, you know?
Good example, Lisa. Drug dealers investing in legit sources like real estate. Right.
Oh, Zero Jules. I definitely watch Breaking Bad. I'm just trying to play coy about it. I'm just trying to get a simple understanding of what's possible.
Okay, so Alex Murdaugh would be embezzling money.
Yeah. Well, he had access to it all, so that makes it real dangerous. Like, that's why those people that work together like that have to trust one another. They're just like slush funds just sitting around that people, slicksters can get in there and just take it. It's dirty business.
Hey, Zero Jules. Good to see you.
So, yeah, I don't know what else I can say about the goings on this past week other than that. Shame on them. And no, ma'am, you can't see any of my private paperwork. It's a weird ask. I mean, you can't say I'm against the freedom of speech if you're trying to make me shut up. Awkward for you, bud.
Oh, you only just tuned in and heard ask about money laundering. Didn't hear anything before that.
Oh, yep. No, I was just curious, like how it worked.
Money Palace. Oh, swindling.
Swindling's a good one. You can swindle someone by bamboozling them too. That's a great sentence. I don't know. Like, I've been accused of being envious of channels making money. That's not, I promise you. I can't judge that. Wouldn't dare. There was like, I did get pretty pissed off like around the holidays, around Christmas time, when like I know that there are like single moms probably in and around that woman's neighborhood. And meanwhile, she's pretending to be a single mom in order to get more donations to a legal fund that nobody really gives a shit about. I did feel a way about that. Not because I wanted to, because I observed it and I was like, that's fucking gross. You know how many people could be helped with that money? I mean, I don't know an exact number, but hundreds. So But aside from that, I'm not personally envious of her ill-gotten money. No, ma'am.
What is the AMAC? What is the Tinder swindler? I've never heard of that story.
I think he was a, I'm not sure if it's a crime story. I might have it mixed up, but I think he was just like a gigolo that pretended to be a Rockefeller or something. I don't know. AMAC knows better. She's on it. I'm not sure.
Okay, so Healing Time has heard of it too. Netflix. I don't have Netflix. I'll have to just Google it and read about it.
So what's going on with you guys? I did kind of tune out for a couple of days there. I think it was the right time to do it because, boy, they've been on my nuts hardcore. Like that. Quite a thing to see.
Okay, so the Tinder swindler pretended to be rich, yet somehow got women to loan him money, met them on Tinder. He conned women out of millions of dollars. Wow.
Yeah, I think he became popular even after being convicted of it. That's funny. So he's just a fucking gigolo, basically. I mean, that's as old as time. That'll be the next thing. So I'll be accused of being a gigolo.
What was that movie? Something Male Gigolo?
Deuce Bigelow.
Deuce Bigelow, that's right, with Rob Schneider, right?
Yeah. Classic. Oh, yes, Fleeced. That's another good one. Snookered is a good one.
Oh, wow. He would tell the women his enemies were after him and he would pay them back, but he was basically taking the next girl on expensive trips. So just constantly just taking money. Wow.
No, I haven't resorted to asking ladies on YouTube for money yet, guys. Don't panic. Although if my tent on the beach gets one more hole in it, you just never know.
Might have to start grifting for a new one.
Exactly. I need a more spacious tent and maybe a little Coleman stove. We'll start there. Sounds. I would actually rock that grift and then go take it to fucking somebody that needs it. Assholes.
Yeah, I sent my life savings to a foreign prince. Next, you know, it's time for Dr. Phil. Okay, solo Ponzi scheme. Yeah.
It's real.
It's terrible.
Yeah, I mean, people are so greedy. It's like something happens, the negative to your existence whenever you start worshiping money like that, you know. I'm not saying all money, but like if it's the most important thing, then it's something's not right. We all need money. It's just the way it goes. But if you already have enough and you're just, your eyes are getting bigger and you're getting greedier, then you're, whether you know it or not, you're worshiping that shit, and that's not going to be good for you. It's never been good for anyone else that happened to. So that's how we know it's not good for you.
Oh, or Lisa, I knew what you meant. Yeah. Autocorrect. Yep, they do. They prey on lonely people or, you know, They just keep moving until they find someone they can manipulate and con.
Yep, it's just like any other grifter. They practice up and they figure out what works, and they figure out what's not going to work, and then they just roll it out. You know, before you know it, you might have 15,000 people just willing to give you money.
Yes, and everyone hit the like if you
Yeah.
haven't already. We
Yeah, thanks for
appreciate
being here.
it.
Yeah, glad everyone's here. I mean, wasn't even sure we wanted to do this one today, to be honest, because it's like, fuck, man, how I'm just gonna keep repeating ourselves that nope, they're still fucking wrong. They still don't have it right. Like, it turns out they're never gonna get it right. So, I'll just have to handle the defamation way a different way and let them just keep fucking stepping in their own shit. It's fine with me.
Oh, you had to pay into the feds, but got so you made a profit, Lisa. You made a profit. I always have them take more out every paycheck, so then during tax season I get more back.
Smart way to do it.
Yes, don't forget your taxes. Taxes are due very soon.
I mean, what happens in a complicated situation? Let's say you have a big dumb legal fund occurring. How's that shit taxed?
Well, I mean, anything over $300 now, you get, I don't know what the actual form is, but you get a form that you have to claim
Even if it's
as
like a,
income.
even if it's a big pity party, like self-made charity, like they've got going at the Hive.
I mean,
Maybe
I don't know how it works, but
it's
I
called
just
a
know
fund.
that if you, I don't know, like PayPal never used to do that, and now they do. So, oh, 1099. Thank you, AMAC.
Sheesh, it sounds complicated. Maybe she could take some of that slush fund money and go ahead and hire an accountant. Right? I mean, shit. Seems like the accountant's gonna be doing a lot more work than her fucking lawyer had to do. I'm just saying.
So Willow said, "Bah ha ha! Tax returns, huh? PayPal pool in 3, 2, 1."
Wild. But I mean,
Oh
really, for me,
wow, AMAC.
it's less about the money because it's really just I never supported the lawsuit on either side from the beginning. I think that I thought they were big dummies. Many of us did. You know, I know it to be true. It's a fact. It's just still going on. That's the problem. It's like grueling, just waiting for the dumb shit to be over.
And AMAC said someone recently said their child support payments got taxed because of Cash App or something similar.
Strange.
Yeah, because Cash App is the same. I think it's 300 or 600 they start taxing.
Yeah, that's like recently occurred, right? It used to be much
Hey,
higher than that.
Kara. Remy, I was wondering that too because I know. We so for the rescue I work with, we always have our adopters do it through friends because if you do it through services, PayPal will take a cut. But I don't know how that works for tax purposes. Oh wow, Lisa said I had one 1099 and even with the $1,000 deductions I was allowed, I still had to pay. And I believe the 1099 was only for only $750. Wow.
Wow, so that's going to be a lot of taxes for Queen Bee for all that Cash App money she collected. I mean, geez, how do you keep track of that? I don't envy that accountant. No, ma'am. Mm-mm.
Well, and there was one last thing I wanted to say, because as I'm an animal lover, especially cats, you know, and even though, you know, there were a couple of people who said that I was the cat lady who could smell cat urine as soon as I walked into a room, I do want to say to Queen Bee that even though that's a pretty low insult, I understand what it's like losing a fur baby. I've done it repeatedly, and I'm sorry that you're going through that because it's not easy. And I just wanted to tell you that even though you're still throwing shade at me. Because again, I don't envy what you're going through because I know that it's one of the worst feelings ever that you can feel as a pet parent. So,
yeah, I don't share that sentiment.
I mean, no, I know you don't, but I do because
I'll tell you why though. I mean, I feel like I have to say why I don't, because and maybe it'll make sense that someone listening, I do feel bad about losing pets. It's horrible to have to do that. But when she described on a Rumble that her poor dog had a lemon sized tumor, like I was fucking dead. I was done. What a despicable thing. Like, how upset can you be that you're going to include an insult about me in it? Fucking sicko.
Yeah. So, I mean, there's a lot of people who share your sentiment, Sinner, but I just know that even though someone can be an asshole and still throw insults at me, I can actually have a little bit of empathy for them and what they're going through because I've been there several times, and I just get it. I mean, yeah. Last fall, I lost 4 in as many months. And I mean, you can be an asshole, but still deserve a little bit of empathy for what you're going through, because it's not just her. It's, you know, everyone else affected by it. So,
yeah,
you know, we may hate each other, but I can, you know, send a little bit of good vibes to get through it. So,
yeah, you are a much better person than me because I don't give a fuck. After what she said to me, I would first have to have respect for her even a little bit to be empathetic towards her.
So as of right now, Queen Bella, she has not. However, her one dog is not doing very well. So, you know, even if I don't like someone, I can still, you know, because I actually have empathy, unlike other people who have blatantly stated they have no empathy, which makes you a psycho. Just saying. Anyways, that's all I wanted to say in regards to that, because I get it.
That's very nice of you. What's up, Miss Robin?
Hey, Miss Robin, what's going on? I haven't seen you in a little while. All right, Glow. Good luck with the vacuum cleaner. Good luck with the vacuum cleaner.
Okay, yes. And that appointment, too. Let us know what's going on.
Oh, you got a new puppy, Miss Robin? Oh, my gosh. What kind of puppy did you get? Oh boy, AMAC. Wasn't that Warren G? Are you singing Warren G, AMAC?
If someone could drop Glow's link in, that'd be super cool.
Oh yeah, I can do it real quick.
See, it might. Okay.
Oh, Steph beat me to it.
Oh, sweet. Thank you.
Oh, her name is Poppy, and she's a Great Dane mix. Oh, Boxer Great Dane. Oh my gosh, you're gonna have a hyper doggy. Well, Great Danes are pretty calm, but Boxers are hyper. They're very. Oh, Dr. Dre. Okay, well.
Yeah, my family dog is a boxer. I don't live with it though, back in Pittsburgh. It's a pretty badass dog. They always have problems with their intestines though, for some reason. Got to keep an eye on that. They can't eat too fast, it can be real bad. The first time I saw one of those dog food mazes, it's like a bowl with like a maze built into it. So they can't eat too fast. It takes too much work, so it physically paces them.
I know, right, Lisa? Very interesting mix. Oh, okay, Remy. My boxers weren't too hyper. They're so cute, however, they're super prone to cancer. Oh, no. Yeah, boxers are very hyper. One of my cousins had a boxer, and oh my gosh. I mean, I was exhausted just hanging out with them for a couple of hours. Oh, Piper. That's a cute name too, Lisa. Piper. Oh my gosh, Pippa. Wow, so Poppy. There's a Poppy, a Piper, a Pippa. Growing up, we had one dog. Well, actually, before I was born, my parents had a dog. But then after I was born, we had Sable, who was a collie. And then when I was maybe in middle school, maybe like sixth grade, we got a poodle beagle mix, and her name was Molly.
My dog growing up was named Lisa. Pretty
Interesting name
lame,
for a dog.
pretty lame name, I know. And then the my sister's dog is named Coda.
Oh, that's a cool name, Coda.
Coda's the boxer. She's from Hawaii. A family friend brought her from Hawaii and couldn't take care of her, so sweet dog. But yeah, super energetic.
Oh, so Pippa, sober pug, sober pug's pug's name is Pippa. That's cute. Pippa the pug. Oh,
Yeah.
Piper is a girl kitty. My bad, Lisa. Piper's a girl kitty. I don't think I have any cats with a name that starts with a P. And of course I'd name them all, but we'd be here all night, so you know.
Probably.
Well, no. I mean, obviously. I do have many cats, though. All of them rescues. Oh no, I do have a cat. Her name is Patra, which is short for Cleopatra. I call her Patty. And she came from outside my house, and she was pregnant. She had her babies. Her babies were adopted really quickly. All of her babies were after Greek gods and goddesses, and Patty wouldn't let me touch her for almost 2 years, so she ended up being adopted by me.
Each 2 years is a long time.
Yes, Remy. So Blizzard and Gingerbread, yes, they have been adopted. Yes. Yep, they were. and one of my mama cats was adopted. I only have the one mama left, and I have integrated her in with my crew, although her Decker, who is the mom, the foster kitty that I have, she and my one feral, they just go at it. And it's like, oh my God, like you're going to have to go back into your room if you keep fighting with each other. Like, just, you know, go somewhere else in the house. Why do you have to be in the same spot?
Good advice. Go watch something else. Why do you have to sit here and fight with each other?
Yeah, or just, I don't know, go in a different room. Remy, yeah, I have really bad allergies to cat dander. Kitten fur gets me, like, kitten fur is really bad. But alas, I don't care. Which room? They have their own little kitten room. Yeah. I turned one of my bedrooms into a kitten room. Yep. Thrown out most. I don't know what that emoji is. Oh, he's allergic to the spit. And he's also allergic to apple peels. Oh my gosh. Oh no, not cash, cats. Yeah, I don't enunciate my T's. Yeah, Grandma Sherry, me too. Daily Zyrtec. Daily Zyrtec. See you, Miss Robin. Have a good one. Oh, and Remy, your kid, he inherited the apple peel thing. Oh my gosh, there's got to be something, like maybe.
I don't know. I know there's a chemical in apple peels that, like, if you were to eat
an apple. Is it resin?
No, it's actually some gnarly chemical. It's naturally occurring. If you eat an apple the very first thing in the morning, it'll wake you up. Well, it's in theory wakes you up more efficiently than a cup of coffee, because there's a chemical in the skin that interacts with your stomach in such a way that it awakens your entire nervous system in like a real direct way. I haven't really tried it, but I have read about it. So it's probably whatever that is that they're allergic to, because if it can do that to a person, what's it doing to an animal?
Wow. I know it. Who is Jessica Willow? All right, well, I've got nothing else.
Yeah, I feel like I would just fucking be repeating myself if I keep at it. I guess to summarize, no thank you. No ma'am, can't see any of my fucking paperwork. Weird thing to ask for. So sorry. And that projection from Timmy saying I'm against free speech is funny, because they're upset about my speech and they're trying to cancel me. So saying I support cancel culture, also real backwards, Timmy, considering you're actively trying to cancel me. Estupido. But aside from that, man, thanks for coming and listening, guys. I'll see you soon.
Yes, and I am planning on not being live tomorrow, but definitely stay tuned for Wordsy Wednesday next week. And I will be working on some shorts tonight, so look for those as well.
Yes, I'm going to be putting out some shorts showing my train trip. Chew fucking chew.
Choo choo.
Choo choo, right, motherfucker. Y'all. Thanks for coming, everybody. Take care.
All right. Have a good one, everybody.
Peace.
Peace.